Children, I am waiting for my friends. We are going out for lunch. Did you hear that growling noise? What was it?
It was my stomach growling.
What makes our stomachs growl? And what does it mean?
When we hear our stomachs make that noise, we know that it has been too long since we have eaten anything. It means that we are hungry.
All living things need food to survive. But why?
Food provides both a source of energy as well as the building blocks to help your body grow, develop, and repair itself.
Imagine that your teacher has assigned you the difficult task of building a castle out of blocks. What do you need?
Well, blocks.
Could you build a block castle without any blocks?
Just like you need blocks to build a castle, your body needs the blocks of life to build itself.
These blocks are taken into your body through your mouth by the process of eating.
Instead of toy blocks, your body uses food.
We eat different kinds of food. All food items contain substances useful to our body. These are known as nutrients. The different food items contain nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Some of these nutrients give us energy. Some help us to grow and some help us to fight diseases. Apart from these, we need water.
Let us try to understand where each of the nutrient comes from and how it works for us.
Carbohydrates. Carbohydrates come mainly from grains like wheat or rice and from beans. The body breaks down carbohydrates into sugars. Your brain runs on sugar, so it makes sense to give it the best kind. The kind that is naturally in foods like rice, potatoes, whole grain bread, and vegetables and fruits. This type of sugar, known as complex sugar, is absorbed into the body slowly, which gives you energy over a long time. Simple sugar, like the white sugar you see in most sugar bowls, has been processed. The body uses it up immediately. It doesn't do you any good. Proteins. Proteins come from meat, fish, poultry, milk, and eggs. Also from pulses and legumes. Your body uses proteins to build new cells, particularly muscle cells. So if you want to be strong, you know what to eat. Fats. We need a certain amount of fat to keep our internal organs warm and to provide energy when we exercise. We can get good fats from nuts, oil, butter, ghee. But it is important not to eat too much as it can make us overweight. Vitamins. The vitamins keep us healthy. These protect us from various diseases. We need vitamins only in small quantities. Fresh fruits and vegetables, milk, fish, meat, eggs gives us vitamins. The food items rich in vitamins are known as protective foods. The vitamins are named as vitamin A, B, C, D, E, and K. Vitamin D is made in our body with the help of sunlight. Thus, sunlight is the natural source of vitamin D. Minerals. Minerals also keep us healthy and fit. They help us to build strong bones, teeth, and blood. We get minerals from fresh fruits, vegetables, milk, etc. Vitamins and minerals are found in most foods, especially vegetables and fruits. Our bodies only need small amounts, but they tend not to stay in the body for long. So we need to eat foods containing lots of vitamins and minerals every day.
So, how the food that we eat is made into the building blocks of our body? Through the process of digestion, your body breaks the food down into the basic blocks of life and then rebuilds them by incorporating them into your body. Just like if you were to take apart a Lego dinosaur so that you could use the blocks to build your castle. Your body is constantly breaking food down and then using the pieces to build, repair and grow your body.
There are many parts or organs utilized by your digestive system. The job of each of these organs is to break down food into smaller pieces or smaller blocks so that by the time the food reaches the cells of your body.
Let's consider a delicious vada for a moment. Although it smells really good in its current form, that vada will not do your body much good. It is much too large to squeeze into your tiny cells. Even if you could get it into one of your cells, that cell would not be able to use it. What do we need to do the vada before we put it into your cells? That's right, we need to break it down into smaller pieces.
As you lift the vada up towards your mouth, what is the first thing you do to begin breaking it down into smaller pieces? That's right, you bite it. The vada is too big to swallow in one giant gulp, so you bite the end off. Already, you have begun breaking it down, haven't you? But wait! Now what are you doing? You are still breaking it down into smaller pieces. You are squishing it and grinding it and cutting it using your teeth. Something else very important is also happening. Your mouth produces a chemical called saliva, which is more commonly referred to as spit. Saliva is produced by your salivary glands and is released as you begin to chew. It can also be released when you smell something yummy. Saliva has a couple of important jobs to perform. First, it moistens your food. This makes it easier to chew and helps lubricate it so that it can travel through your body more easily. Saliva also contains chemicals that begin to break your food down into smaller pieces through the process of chemical digestion.
Now, you're holding a vada in your hand with a bite missing out of it. In your mouth, you have a small wet ball of mashed up vada. You swallow it. That wet ball of broken up vada begins a long journey towards the cells of your body. At this point, it is still too big to fit inside any of your tiny cells. Even the smallest pieces would be far too large to do your cells any good.
After swallowing your vada bite, it enters into your esophagus or the food pipe. The esophagus is like a long slippery water slide. Muscles within your esophagus squeezes the food down towards your stomach. Whether you are standing up, lying down or hanging upside down, you can safely swallow a bite of food because the muscles within your esophagus know that their job is to send food in only one direction, towards your stomach. As that vada bite falls into the stomach, a round muscle called a sphincter closes behind it. This protects the esophagus from having food or other chemicals splash back into it. The single vada bite is soon joined by other bites as you continue eating. After a few minutes, your stomach is completely full.
Because you feel full, you stop eating and run off to play with your friends. As you play, you don't think about the food or what it is doing inside of you. But your body does not forget about it. Deep within you, your body continues the process of breaking your food down into smaller and smaller pieces.
For the next couple of hours, your stomach muscles churn and grind the food in your stomach, causing it to roll over and over again. Glands within your stomach releases a variety of powerful chemicals which help to further break down the food within you. The two most important chemicals are hydrochloric acid and pepsin. Together, these chemicals down into a slush known as chyme. Once the chyme is ready, a valve opens in your stomach and releases the chyme into your small intestine. The small intestine is where most of the digestion process takes place. Although the slushy chyme is much more broken down than the original hot dog, the small pieces floating in the chyme are still too large to fit inside your cells. They must be broken down even further. As the chyme enters your small intestine, it is mixed with a variety of chemicals whose job is to further break down the vada. Your liver adds a liquid known as bile, which helps to neutralize the acids from your stomach so that digestion can continue to take place.
By now, you are done playing with your friends and are back at home watching television. The chyme is slowly moving further along in your small intestine. As it moves along, the process of digestion is almost complete. Your small intestine is lined with tiny folds called villi.
The muscles within your small intestine squeeze and roll the food about. As it sloshes around, these villi quickly absorb the nutrients from the chyme, leaving behind the materials that are not nutritious. As chyme enters your large intestine, there are virtually no nutrients left. The job of the large intestine is to remove water from the remaining waste. Water is very important to your body and it cannot afford to allow water to leave unnecessarily. It is sent to the kidneys. Slowly, the chyme passes through your large intestine, becoming drier and harder. It is then thrown out of the body through the anus.
There are a few things that we can do to help healthy digestion. We have been told about these habits by our elders so many times. Can you remember them? Let's list them.
Take food at fixed hours. Chew the food well. Do not overeat. It causes uneasiness and indigestion. Have a balanced diet having carbohydrates, proteins, and vitamins. Do not eat when you are angry, afraid, or worried. The place where you eat your food must be clean and tidy. Eat green vegetables every day. Drink plenty of water. Wash your hands before eating. Wash your mouth and clean your teeth after every meal. Never eat in between meals. This will spoil your appetite. Have a fixed time to toilet. Have a fixed time of toilet.
Have you noticed we eat both raw and cooked food? Why do you think we cook our food?
Proper cooking makes food tastier. Cooking makes food soft and easy to digest. Cooking kills germs present in the food. It makes food harmless. When we eat raw food, we must always make sure that the food is washed well. This will remove any dust and germs present on the surface.
So, how do we cook the food? There are many ways of doing so.
Roasting is used for making rotis, biscuits, cakes and breads are made by baking. Puris and vadas are deep fried. Deep frying improves the taste of food. Rice and idlis are steamed. Steaming makes food light and easy to digest.
Friends, one must always remember a few things when cooking food. We may call these good cooking habits.
Good cooking habits. The vegetables should be washed before cutting them. We should not wash vegetables after cutting because in doing so, certain vitamins and mineral salts are lost. Do not throw the water in which vegetables pulses or grams are soaked or boiled. It may contain vitamins and minerals. Food should be cooked in clean utensils using clean water. Food must be cooked with just enough water. Overcooking should be avoided. Overcooking destroys the vitamins present in the food.
Next time you help your mother in the kitchen, remember these rules and also tell these to the others around you. That way, all of us will become healthier. All foods will spoil when kept at room temperature after some time. Such foods lose color and taste. But we can use different methods to delay this process. We should protect the food from getting spoiled. Cooked and uncooked food can be stored to be used later. This kind of storing is called preservation.
Let us talk about some common methods of food preservation. Storing the food at low temperature. When the food is stored at low temperature, it is not easily spoiled. This can be done by placing the food in a refrigerator. We can keep our cooked or uncooked foods like eggs, milk, vegetables and fruits in the refrigerator. Storing in airtight containers. The food may be preserved in airtight containers. These containers keep away moisture and help in preserving food for a longer time. They also keep away insects, rodents and vermin. That is why we keep grains in airtight boxes. Boiling. Boiling is a common method of preserving food. It destroys germs which spoil food. Milk is commonly boiled in homes to preserve it for shorter period. Keeping in sugar syrup. Concentrated sugar syrup is also a good preservative. It prevents the growth of bacteria. Various jams are preserved in this way. Remember the delicious murabbas and aam papars we eat? They are made in this manner. Drying. Some food items are preserved in a dried form. Cauliflowers, peas and chilies are commonly dried for using them out of season. Dried fish also relies on this principle. Salting. Some food items are preserved in solutions of salt. Salt absorbs water and forms a thick solution. Bacteria cannot grow in this solution. Pickles are preserved by this method. Always remember, food should be stored in proper places to prevent exposure to dust and germs. All the food items should be properly covered or stored so that flies and insects do not sit on them. The germs of diseases are carried by flies. Uncovered food should not be eaten. It causes many diseases such as diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, dysentery, vomiting and jaundice.
I'm sure you all must be remembering how our mother and grandmothers kept telling us these very things. How many times have we been upset with them for telling these things over and over again? Next time, we will tell them that we should always clean our hands before and after eating. Eat clean food. Good food keeps us healthy. Also, that we all need food. All food items contain nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Foods are of different kinds. Energy-giving foods, bodybuilding foods and protective foods. We should take a balanced diet. Digestion is a process in which food is changed into a simpler form that can be absorbed by the body. Digestive juices from our mouth, stomach and small intestine help to digest the food. Cooking makes the food soft, tasty and easily digestible. Food needs to be protected and preserved. Food is cooked by boiling, roasting, baking, steaming or frying. Don't you think they will be surprised when we tell them all this and follow it too? For now, I am very hungry and my friends are here too. So, let me go and have lunch with them. Children, see you the next time. Bye-bye.